By the bin.
Quakers ex-sex of the charters.
Hoy va a ser chiste, ¿verdad?
¿Usted dice?
Dan moet je een kwaliteit maken naar
van. Wat
iemand naar wijf?
Ben Mersin Polozan, Helsinki Komitetinden, Makedonya'dan, Arnavut.
Tamam. Makedonya dili bize çok yakın, biz nasıl anlaşıyoruz?
Мы бы хотели вот построить так нашу
страну.
Нас интересует, как вы решаете социальные, экономические, скажем даже политические проблемы. Вы опыт. И, наверное, после этого вы могли тоже. Может, ваша информация небольшая. А после этого, чтобы...
В основном из Македонии здесь представители. Ну, Македония сейчас самостоятельное государство. Может быть, у них там проблемы есть внутри сейчас государства.
До 5% украинского. Около 3%. Гагаузы как народ, который сохранили
their national identity, which kept their traditions, language, way of life, are located only in the territory of Бастарайо.
Основная масса, проживающая лет 200 тому назад на Балканах, где Черноморские районы, районы Варна, Коварна.
Критики тех государств привели почти к полной ассимиляции гагаузов.
As a result of the policy carried out by that state, the Gagauz population has almost assimilated with their local one.
Это Румыния, где гагаузов почти не показывают уже по первичке.
I'm talking about the Romania, where the last census doesn't show any Gagauz nationality. Ten years ago, the census stated 10,000 Gagauz population, and now the last census stated 2,000.
В месячный срок предложение внести парламенту по изменению законов Молдовы.
Also, the decree states that the government should make a concrete proposal to the parliament during 1 month to send the second article provides for adjustment of the minister's level regulation. All the other state organizations should annihilate their own laws.
Поэтому мы приходим в противоречие с законами Республики Молдова, любыми законами. Что бюджет Гагаузии формируется так-то, так-то, так. И все. От налогов внутренних мест.
So far we can elaborate our own budget having under the local taxes collection.
Статья 18 закона.
Where? co-produkcija na Makedonska televizija i Art televizija.
This is a co-production of the Macedonian National Television and Art Television.
И со жаление вчера, завчера дознав дека авторот на химната на Гагаузија не е меѓу живите.
Unfortunately, I understand
Па затоа...
Насколку ја понял, несколько дни тому назад скончался автор группы Лига.
Мина Чосе. Така да, Мина Чосе ќе го видите уште еднаш на ова филмска лента.
Now you have the opportunity to see this gentleman on the screen.
Дозволите ми да го
видите
на
ентрогаспетина
на ентрогаспетина.
Vi är där med.
Marksi Engels i Danmark, en Beri. Sjuksjö.
Margalen.
A snimi ovde, ovde knjih što smo bile. Dobre. A Maja, ja snimi Maja.
Da, da, da.
Чекај, чекај.
И тоа
што Арта пушти ова.
Поче пуштим сега.
Поздравите.
Најубаво време кој ќе биде.
Поздрави ги сите сега.
Еве да ги позовем свите дедово.
Да, види ја, гледај. Што рекламираме сега?
За весела.
Кафе беше чудно.
But it was 10th years anniversary of the Gagauz Republic, and we have the 10th years anniversary of the Gagauz University.
Три отделения у нас: начальное образование, дошкольное воспитание и музыкальная педагогика.
We have three departments.
Этот хор в прошлом году был записан на гостелерадио Молдовы. Исполнял он 7 гагаузских песен. У нас есть кассеты с 7 гагаузскими песнями.
The recording has been recorded at the
Okay, mi ne planirat zakasnit noću, ali mi zakasnit, tako.
Ja sam У нас есть представители из Македонии, Албании, Болгарии, Венгрии. Это программа, финансированная фондом Сороса и Института открытого общества из Будапешта. Первый этап программы был в июне, когда группа экспертов из Молдовы посетила Македонию рабочий визит. Мы посетили вот так тоже разные с местными властями нескольких городов. После этого был круглый стол. Та же схема и для Молдовы. Мы посетили Кишинев, вчера был Кишинев, сегодня в Кишинев. И вот наши такой вот способ разнообразить нашу программу, и вместо того, чтобы в Казахстан приехали, в Казахстан. И мы очень рады, что вы в нашем деле их решаете. Вообще, может, немного рассказать. И если по ходу возникнут вопросы, наверное, были бы, что каждого интересует. В группе интересуются проблемами, как построить взаимопонимание между гражданами в определенной стране, вне зависимости от любого характера. Вот это нас интересует. А в понедельник, то, что вот они видели здесь, и каково их мнение, и что мы, как мы думаем, что было бы лучше.
You know, it is the Bulgarian district, the only Bulgarian district for us in Moldova. Mr. Ivan.
Вы можете начать, чтобы мы немножко обогрелись, да? А потом уже...
Предприятие само, винзавод, было образовано в 1958 году.
The winery was established in 1958 as their state-owned company.
Вина поставляют то же, что назвал вот молодой человек. Но также мы поставляем вина в Китай.
And we are selling our wines the same direction as
Канаду.
Was mentioned before. Plus, we are exporting them to China, Canada.
Ну, в основном мы пользуемся старым нашим рынком Россия. 80% товарной продукции идет в Россию.
But the 80% of the to get the best wheat in the Republic this year, best, and we have the best output of the wheat in the Republic.
В уезде существуют 22 школы средних специалистов для младших классов с уклоном болгарский язык.
And another college trains the teachers.
При этом бюджет, уездный бюджет берет на себя содержание на 50%, и экономические агенты, которые, на которых на территории расположены эти сельско-участковые больницы, добровольно взяли себя 50% расход на содержание этих агентов.
Have a different healthcare system if for the Moldova the rural hospitals have been eliminated. Here we have the system like this.
Can do it today because tomorrow we have a larger audience and we have a structured series of roundtables. So practically, it means that for the distinguished participants, today is the day when they can, I mean, if I understand it, speak up in a formal way.
A detailed presentation paper. Your papers will be included into a final volume on the experience of the two societies on social problem solving. So anyhow, we have your presentation to focus on major points. My suggestion would be to listen to 4, 5, 6 papers. It depends on how much we have for the first of the program. And then we have
asked to me who would be interested in speaking in the first round for just understanding. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So we have six contributors to remaining, and then I will not automatically stop you in 10 minutes, but I will somehow ask you, I mean, to finish it, because otherwise, I mean, the six papers should be not discussed properly. Probably, if means if we have less presenters for this third and fifth, I mean, after the sixth presentation. So may I just, I mean, to suggest just, I mean, a physical order coming from here and going, I mean, to the other end of the table. Askaru will be the first. So Anna, please go ahead. If you want to, yeah, you can speak up at your place. You can come to this place. And yes, okay, please. So everybody is speaking up, I mean, from his or her place at the table.
A lot
for
many times in this case.
You translate
I
into
English.
Yeah, you okay, fine, go
in English.
Yeah, okay, good.
Atunci când am pornit aceste anumite Macedonia pentru că avem foarte multe similitudini.
We chose Macedonia because there are a lot of similarities between them and our country.
Prima similitudine este că ambele state sunt state noi formate după căderea societăților sau mega statelor.
The first similarity between the two countries is that
tot ce încearcă să facă o societate nouă este de a se apropia de cele care deja au tradiții.
In this context, everything that a new region and the Lord is a combination.
Ce înseamnă legi venesc pentru societatea asta a înțelege cum povestim împreună, diferență de naționalitate, confesie și apartenență politică.
What does it mean to unwritten law? This is a way of surviving together, irrespective of...
Este adevărat. Noi ne-am înțeles, adică am învățat în lista.
Without having these abilities, we came to torn away the communication that we can come across with.
Și atunci, în dependență, unde ne aflăm? Fiecare societate unde se află? Se află la o sferă de interese, în unii puteri care dorește să mențină
pace, libertate și știu, dezvoltarea acestui societate, pentru că factorul extern, așa, într-o formă foarte voalată, menține într-o stare de stres întreaga societate.
Because the extreme
in Moldova,
and this is the big difference.
Ați reușit să vedeți că neavând minorități etnice, neavând minorități confesionale.
You have the sensation that we are coming back to the novel Umberto Eco in another century.
Ce ar însemna aceasta din punct de vedere simbolic? La insula zilei de ieri.
If in the novel Umberto Eco there were only two people who wanted to come back into yesterday,
atunci frontierele pe care le-am văzut noi, liderii politici încearcă să ducă înapoi.
And if you look into your notes that you have done, then you can see that there are 650,000 people in Transnistria and 150 in
La dumneavoastră, factorul extern nu se implică în explozia oamenilor, adică societății din interior.
Because if in your society...
După mine, foarte important, care noi trebuie să discutăm și sper că dumneavoastră o să mă auziți, pentru că timpul meu cam expiră.
And a very important moment that I would like us to discuss.
В областта на прописите почнувате од 89-та година. Незадоволството се
Not only the Macedonians but also the Albanians were constitutional people.
Со амандманите од 89-та година овој статус се укинува.
There were amendments in 1989. From the amendment that was done in 1989, this was abolished.
И 1991 година со уставот.
And then with the new constitution from the 1991.
Во преамбулата Македонија се конституира како национална држава на македонскиот народ.
In the general part of the constitution, the Republic of Macedonia has been constituted as the national state of the Macedonian people.
Во која се обезбедува граѓанска равноправност на другите меѓу кои и албанци.
And civil equality has been provided for all other nationalities that live in the Republic of Macedonia.
Духот на степенувањето провејува и во нормативниот дел од уставот, член 7, 48.
Well,
се но се третира како службен јазик.
And in all these laws we can say that the only official language that we have that is treated is Macedonian.
Албанскиот не само што
been used in some units of the local government.
Најголем проблем и понатака останува високото образование.
But I can say that the biggest problem stays the actually is the higher education.
Кој се тежи да се
Prohibit state institutions.
Проблем со прописи представува и нерегулирањето на употребата на албанскиот јазик во парламентот.
Also we have problem with the constitution when we are talking about using the Albanian language in the parliament.
Право кое исто така постои со стариот дело. Пасто кажете улиците, надписите на фирмите
и мините на
Well, this is like using the Albanian language in the public area, in the public presence, in the system of justice. And the power to the people.
И проблемот со билингвалноста поресно би се решило на локално ниво.
And I think that the problem with the bilinguality would be much easier. It would be easier to solve on a local level.
Албанците во западниот и северозападниот дел на Република.
So at the same time they can feel the benefits of the
migration. И горчината на дискриминација.
But also the bitterness of the people who forget their own mother language.
Во консенсусот гледат можност.
In the consensus they are seeing an opportunity.
За избегнување на така наречената тортура на мнозинството.
With the relations between the states and ethnic groups started and many people and diplomats and even politicians were caught by a fever of hope at that time. And they were thinking that, you know, the time had come for for the European identity, the division, and the Iron Curtain had fallen down. And but these hopes were sort of a short leash, because what we saw from the breakup of Yugoslavia and four ethnic wars there were contrary to these expectations and hopes. And from an Albanian perspective, I just want to give you a personal example. I'm from Northern Albania, and in 1990, I mean after the borders were sort of crashing down, the brother of my grandmother came in my home to visit us, and I was present, I witnessed it. We're old, thanks to God. And her brother was 90 years old. They had lived for 45 years divided with a border which was, and they realized that we had Albanians not only in Albania but also in former Yugoslavia. Try to be consistent with the official figures. And the bad thing so far is that we don't have official figures of the Albanian population in Macedonia, because we have some figures from Albanians which say, yeah, they are 30, 35, or some probably exaggerated, who say 40%, but they are the...
Of the non-profitable factories have crossed the streets every day. But the pupils have stroke also. The pupils who study in the multilingual schools, in other words, who live in the multilingual environment and consequently study in the schools with many groups, or at least, if it is possible, they want to be prevented from the mixing with them in the halls or in the schoolyard. Namely, they pose the claim to have the school some hours aim of education. Developed on the very beginning of socialistic organization, suggested as an imperative on the equality and the democracy, as a part of the genuine right of the children to learn on their maternal language, this policy, with the details necessary to point two consequences of this policy of multilinguality. The first is the educational segregation. It has introduced an Macedonian language, but with a program that is not sufficient for its adoption on the level of written communication. The pupils, which language of education is Macedonian, Albanian. It does not exist educational subjects who join the children in common activities. There is no possibility to put together all of them. For culture, especially in the present context, in the segment of educational motivation. Namely, it was introduced the system of education made up from more segments as languages of education, everybody of which acts for itself parallel with others.
Changes. I think Anna's not here, but I want to say thank you to Anna, because she's been working 24 hours a day for 6 months on this. I think the program that she made for you all in Chisinau and then traveling in the country was very practical and very provocative, thought-provoking. And what I would like to see happen here today and tomorrow is for you all to really be creative and think and brainstorm on practical ways to deal with this complex situation that you all are involved in your own societies. This is a neutral meeting space. It's not official, it's not, no consequences necessarily. So we want these kinds of exchanges in the EASTEAS program to stimulate change that you can see that will make change, not just an analysis of the situation, what are your ideas from the media perspective? What do you think role and responsibility media can have in overcoming these tensions? What are ways
this network within the Soros Foundation is much more than a conference and travel grant mechanism. This mechanism provides resources and expertise
in what you've heard, specifically in the Moldovan context, is very provocative in your own thinking. So be creative. Interact. Put ideas on the table here to hear your colleagues' response to inform your own thinking in new ways, new ideas. We want something that's very difficult to describe.
Brainstorming session, or as the discussion goes on, to think about what kind of similarities and differences there are. It's very difficult because our impressions are very fresh. Just yesterday that we visited this country, we are I'm really stunned by the situation when the project began under the common title conflicts in ethnic divided societies. I really did not imagine. Compared to Moldova, in Macedonia, it looks like it's more a theoretical division, which has not gone very far, and that there are ways that it can that things could be worked out. But the influences that that are present in the over the state in the one case and in the other, apart from saying that there are strong foreign influences which are common in both situations, there are specifics and big differences. For instance, our Balkan region is at the moment occupied by good, is bad, and in the interview I said the best thing is that for their country is not to have foreign soil. But having in view what has been happening,
combination and are manifested with different strength and intensity in each state apparently. From the political aspect, this group of factors has the strongest effect on the changes in the geopolitical statu quo and preserve its leading role in geopolitical configuration of the region and appearance of a number of new sovereign and religious minority and territorial factors in the formulation and fusions of their foreign policies. The simultaneous appearance of Balkan states in particular and in the region as a whole. The enormous increase in organized crime and the more and frequent acts of the political terrorism. The non-sanctioned spread of traffic in drugs, vehicles, and the heterogeneous influence of the leading international factors on the development of the geopolitical and ethno-minority situation in the region. For example, acceptance of intermediary services, use of in the last few years, there have been serious problems predominantly related to the development of the different stages of the crisis in the former native places. Giving sufficient guarantees of respect and the preservation of the civil and minority rights of those who are willing to return. Creation, pacification in Kosovo, an approach to the gradual normalization and stabilization of the situation in the former Yugoslav geopolitical area. Establishment of the political means for discovering, controlling, and solving the existing crises and problems with active mediation and intervention.
I should hold up some real practical solutions to our common problems.
Я бы хотел коснуться именно ситуацию с масс-медиа в Македонии и Молдове применительно к строительству гражданского общества. Каковы перспективы, то есть развития ситуации, которая существует сегодня?
I would like to talk about the perspectives of development of Macedonian and Moldovan multimedia regarding the building of civil society.
Я выскажу свои впечатления от сопоставления ситуации.
Вопрос такой, как идти дальше, потому что я понял так, что вы будете говорить об общей ситуации. После обеда у нас целая секция масс-медии.
Давайте сделаем как лучше. Я могу сейчас...
Нет, я не хочу вас остановить, просто вы остановили...
A sort of reinterpretation of the citizenship in a society. So a citizenship in a sense that are you member of an ethnic community by blood and by soil? So are you member of a community because your fathers and grandfathers and grandfathers were members of the community and you have just blood? Or that's a very... let's turn it in another way. In the 19th century you had two major models of citizenship. You had the French model and you had the German model. The German model was that German is that who has relation to the German soil and to the German blood. The French solution was that everybody who is citizen of France is French citizen. You can be an Arab, you can be a black, you can be a German in Alsace, you can be a French, who cares about it? If you're ready to speak French, besides of your language, if you're ready to accept the French law, you are defended by that citizenship, but then in that case no cultural rights are given to a minority because you are in Germany. How do we act? What are we doing now? Because what we are doing now, we are trying to stabilize by law this German type of anti-sanctuary to define our nations by blood and soil. And we see more progress in our societies, including minorities and majorities, with promoting that model, searching for legal guarantees in this mutual mistrust, using that, I must repeat, 19... Okay, that's my personal view, probably I'm wrong, but that's very interesting. And we have the third problem coming from. What are we doing with ethnic parts?
If you remember yesterday, we felt similar when Mr. Chairman of Gagauz Parliament said, you have a good relationship with Turkish, but Russia Matushka is more closer than Turkey.
Mother and Russia.
Yes. I hope it's a very dangerous...
Это консервация положения на протяжении последних 8-9 лет. Что говорит в пользу хорошего, позитивного решения, эволюционного? Это Приднестровье, левобережная часть Днестра. Это юг, гагаузские и болгарские регионы, в основном гагаузские. И это то, что иногда называют Бессарабией, просто раньше Бессарабия была больше по размеру.
Я
не индивидуален.
Is individual.
Гати Гитман индивидуален.
Almost. In every case, individual.
За шум индивид порбен коллективе.
And many individuals comprise the collective.
The problem in Macedonia. Гитман мер форман это коллектив.
And the problems and issues in Macedonia always take the minority. It's the citizenship is always or almost always identified with a nation.
The
minority.
Ну прямо чешки аспекты этники.
They're not anymore in sort of the ethnic.
Это материя компликован ситуация.
And this complicates
even more.
What do you think of your thoughts on this?
than Yugoslavia. I did not know, and I very soon realized that nationalism was on the agenda of Yugoslavia, which might have been produced by democracy also. My idea was that moving towards future European integration, identities, becoming members of the United Nations and so on, would create some kind of a confederate body which would down to Macedonia, and now we are the last place in fact. We have had a process of ethnic separation and from their neighbors. There was a lot of talk that Sarajevo is like a tiger skin. I believed in that also. And we saw that it was possible. And it was sometimes the wish of the people.
Republika.
Declared republic.
Во југот на земјата го имаме автономијата на гагаузите.
At the south of the country we have the Gagauz autonomy.
И Молдавија као етничка земја, да.
And like to repeat the words of Mr. Мерсин Полажани.
Значи уставотворен народ да имат право на образование, на високо образование и така.
Well, that they should be constitutional people, that constitutional people and right to higher education.
И во тоа чекате 10 години.
And they're waiting for all these rights for 10 years. Moldova, that in the Moldovan parliament, you use the Moldovan language and also Russian language.
По културата така натаму.
And we can say that besides all these basic human rights, the language, the culture.
Народот во Транснистрија, со народите во Транснистрија, во Трансе...
Law faculty, medicine, economy...
Мислам дека не ги помина посуми.
Благодарам.
In the democratic way. I think there's a kind of a deep predisposition to be resolved in a nationalistic way because the federation itself was artificially created. And we had a federation where for 70 or 80 years, all the ethnic groups there were had also the Serbians regarding them as victims. So it was kind of natural.
Far, I can say, and in my experience so far, last 5 years, NGOs in Macedonia didn't achieve really their goal. Working with the people from different ethnic backgrounds, it's not always easy, and it's always it's not really it's not
in western part of Macedonia they have different perspective what's happening. Those people involved in the NGO activities didn't see that something is happening, that there is some change, or there is a possibility something to be in communities. So it really didn't happen. Although we were trying, many other NGOs, much stronger, they spend much more money, but not really some concrete activities so far.
Overcome the stereotypes and prejudice existing among the people. For those people living in more perspective, one point of view. People living in multi-ethnic communities, they have different point of view. And sometimes we can...
The civil society in Republic of Moldova right now is not living to the peak of its activities, like it was in 1995 and 1996. Moldova is not really an ethnic one. It's more of the territorial. Internal political one. We don't have really many NGOs who work political education or civic education of the population in order to a specific problem is that
у меня сложилось такое мнение, что действительно Андрей прав и слишком законсервирована ситуация.
Living here in Moldova and visiting Macedonia, I agree with Andrei, who said that we are conserving the situation by keeping it without any development.
Люди уже привыкли жить в такой.
Поэтому может иметь смысл менять не законы, конституцию, а начать изменение сознания людей.
Maybe it's better not to change the laws, constitution, the legislation, but try to change the conscience of the people, their way of...
Стараюсь открыть некоторые стратегии работы непосредственно для примера.
And in my report on the NGOs activities, I would like...
In our field of activity, we also work at the inter-ethnic relations.
Увидя дека преку реализација на проекти, ќе влијае во позитивна смисла и ќе придонесе за сваќање дека профа и разликите имаат и многу сличности, без разлика дека припаѓа на меѓунационалностите.
And we think that working together in different issues, in different projects, we think that we can contribute more in developing different they can establish connection
environment.
And you can say the social and religious background is creating problems that we are facing in our everyday life.
Без разлика дали станува збор за жена македонка, точно.
Prejudice.
Односот меѓу нив е недоволна и во незавидна положба.
We can say that their relation is not very well developed.
Бидејќи нивното дружење и комуницирање е недоволно.
Because their communication is on a very low level.
Жените живеат во иста требина.
These women live in the same environment.
Дека ги имат истите проблеми за кои може взаимно да разговарат.
They have the same problems, which means that they can discuss about these problems together.
И преку организирање на разни средби, ќе им се даде можност меѓусебно да се запознат, да се дружат и пријателат.
So that means that organizing meetings, they will be able to get to know each other.
Number of people can influence on the process of adoption of the each ethnic group. I don't mean only Macedonian, but when we speak about the
you have to do it lower your voice because two voices.
Yes, I can. Because the number of two ethnic groups which are in the relation is some kind of determination between each other, particularly from ecological point of view, I mean like environment and to deal with surface and something in some part of land, it means that each variation in the number or size could have reflection on the other. So in the analysis of the multi-ethnic system, it is good to explain or just to describe to some numbers of the process of equitation of the balance between each ethnic group. So I used in some kind of, let's say, the research is just a descriptive analysis or something, because of the lack of data about fertility in our country. It is, we didn't have some kind of this type of research. Even we know that there is, it will be shown the current fertility in Macedonia. The general and short diagnosis of the current fertility in Macedonia will be the following. Population in Macedonia, meaning the general level of the
population.
Yes, I mentioned in my conclusion that, yes, in this figure I don't have, not because of me, because it is published in
the media, so the body and the soul of the society.
И треба да има посебен респект од општеството.
And they should be respected by the society.
Јас ќе се задржам на некои конкретни факти за Македонија.
I'm going to present some concrete facts about the Republic of Macedonia.
Иако не гледам тука наши колеги од Молдавија или од други, па да ги користат евентуално за добро или за лошо.
Although I can't see our colleagues from Moldova,
all know that
Македонија мирно успеа да се одвои од таа средина. А покрај политичарите што допринесува во тоа, допринесува јавните медиуми.
Затоа што
сите ја Република Македонија кој орган на владата на Македонија.
According to the Council of the Radio Diffusion Council of the Republic of Macedonia, which is the governmental body.
Заклучно со октомври, во Македонија, покрај
Македонија.
Во-первых, и это главное в обществе и одной и другой страны не было сколько-нибудь развитых, серьезных демократических традиций. Во-вторых, с самого начала создания независимой и Македонии, и Молдавии, все увидели стремление государства контролировать, если не все, то ведущие масс-медиа.
Secondly, when the independent Macedonia and Moldavia have been created, the government of both countries have started to trying to control the media.
В-третьих, сразу появились масс-медиа, которые имеют привилегии, потому что они выражают интересы либо партии власти, либо больших денег.
Функционируют в гагаузской автономии. Три разновидности.
As the media here has three groups, Moldovan media, which is controlled by and is functioning according to the Moldovan.
The rising situations. We had a couple of years, 2 years before the crisis in Kosovo. On the other hand, 7-8 years ago, maybe 9, you had the crisis in Transnistria. As was told from a colleague of mine, I think it was in the journalist press center here in Moldova, sort of similar situation, maybe not to such extent, we had in Macedonia. We had a TV channel, private TV, that was reacting in such form because of international influences. This is the main problem of our medias, that and maybe also your medias, because I could freely say that instrument of propaganda, because we know the power of medias and also we know the damage they can do in the society. We have very bitter experience from what happened in former Yugoslavia.
I may say that my colleagues mentioned some things and I agree with them, but not about everything.
Задлијањето на моќта на медиумите врз создавањето на јава во лоша конотација самите медиуми.
I think that we can learn situation in Serbia, how medias can be used and misused in this situation.
Во Србија ситуацијата беше тоа што председателот за лоши избора дека тихите медиуми во национална телевизија зема во свој рат.
He actually owned national television and that is the television that was present in every home in the country.
Постојано се пишува и се презентира прилози за историското минато на Србите со што повеќе се зголемуваше оној емоционален дел кај населението и зголемувањето на тензијата.
Which means that on the national television in Serbia all the time there were TV shows were presented and the content
Кажам дека конкретно во Македонија
and I can say that in Macedonia
конкретно за меѓунационалните односи
I would like to speak concretely about the inter-ethnic relations.
Масовните медиуми имаат по-толерантен однос.
I can say that the media in Macedonia have more tolerant approach and attitude.
Целта не беше елиминација на некој народ, него целта беше решавање на некој проблем.
Actually, the goal was not to eliminate a certain people, but to solve certain issues.
Иако мислам дека за некој работи ке...
The message to the Macedonian journalist, he told them that they should bring a translator with him.
Што исто така како напомена можам да кажам дека за луѓето од Молдавија дека официјален јазик во Македонија е македонскиот јазик.
I would like to mention for just for so your information that the official language in Macedonia is Macedonian.
И ваквите начини можеби на некои групи да влијат може токму да зборува за зголемување на тензијата помеѓу едната и другата група.
And this is just an example how this can increase the tension among those two groups.
Сметам дека секој нов
introduction. The Middle East or the usual armed incidents in Kosovo. Maybe the latest intensive bombing in Northern Ireland or even the activities of the separatist movement of the Basque in Spain or French Corsica. This seems to be everyday events.
A conflict between two ethnic groups with a longer history. In time, the feeling of mutual fear and distrust prevails. In that respect, the feeling of discrimination can actually be confirmed within the constitutional framework or discrimination can actually be confirmed with the constitutional framework of a country or in everyday practice. For example, when the cultural and traditional differences between two communities are strengthened by religious differences, that results with the existence of two communities that live one next to another without knowing each other and with no mutual communication. Such communities have an enormous potential for developing ethnic hostility. Therefore, from perspective of the new millennium, we are facing the challenge of overcoming ethnic intolerance that will no doubt be tried. Any kind of extreme positions can be a powerful agent in the conquest of the phantom of fear or suspicion. The ultimate approach can kill any kind of reconciliation process, thus it should be avoided. Still, in a society of information technology and communication boom, usually...
Then we go in the second round. If you have your sentence already, I mean, offered by somebody else, you're just, I mean, passing the round. And then we are, I mean, ask you to vote for the five most important. And then it comes out what is the common opinion of the group. I mean, which are, according to your understanding, the five major issues which should be somehow solved or raised here at the seminar. So my understanding would be like that now you understand the procedure, and now you have your homework. I mean,
Nu vă uitați chiar așa, v-am gândit.
Ce se face?
Da, eu am să vă colind. Suntem în ajunul Sfintelor Sărbători de Crăciun. Ne dați voi să vă colindăm. Primiți colinda.
Primiți colinda, nu?
Doiniță.
Da.
Thank you. Само тебе да слигам, а нищо ти. Ти за брат от нищо не се интересираш.
Din societăți divizate, indiferent, poate nu am dreptate. Această divizare are rând, în primul rând, prin faptul cât de mult sau cât de puțin ne gândim în societatea noastră să ne realizăm fiecare din urmă. A făcut posibil să ne cunoaștem, via, comrat, Cazaiac sau Cazaclia, ce se întâmplă în societatea românească. Și înainte de a oferi cuvântul celor care vor comunica unele concluzii vis-a-vis de cele cercetări pe care le vom face și încercările de a vedea în organizații neguvernamentale cum am putea ajuta inclusiv a unii pregătiți pentru a fi competitivi, iar pe de altă parte, în politice, poate să se realizeze în această societate. În aceste timpuri incerte, să dezvoltăm sentimentul de comunie.
In a process, in a long process of some 10 years. But then I decided to leave that aside and speak about my experience now that after I've seen what we have seen now in Moldova.
There was an idea that the Bosnian War would end, and the Bosnian War was located in the middle of Yugoslavia, so there wasn't any big problem of spillover. But once the communists moved down to the south, and then that meant that the interests of the Western alliance would be seriously jeopardized. I think that is one of the reasons why Europe of the Balkans when the social crisis erupted. In question was the NATO alliance, the credibility of the alliance, and they had to show that there is also force. So all of us who said we wanted to become NATO members, we have to fulfill the criteria, and it would have taken countries, these new small countries that are created, we are not afraid what our neighbor is going to happen. We hear some of my leaders, and I thank you for your attention.
statements which were raised by me yesterday, most of the participants, I mean, with the exception of a few group of Moldavian colleagues, were present yesterday at the source foundation, so I'm not going back to the
that we said yesterday. But mentioning some kind of good points of our common history, Albanians and Macedonians never had an ethnic conflict, never went to war with each other. And that's, I believe, if we do not face the challenges now and address the issues now as they are, the tendency is that they are going to get worse and worse and worse. And in some day, we might reach a situation where the present claims of the ethnic Albanians in Macedonia will be outdated. And then nobody in Macedonia will be speaking of their constitutional right. Nobody will be speaking for their underrepresentation in the state institutions. Nobody will be speaking for for the, you know, we see we cannot be in the society. We want to be part. And also we might have also Macedonians saying that, you know, Albanians are sort of letting things run their course and reach to this point, which I see that there will be no the Macedonians are, I mean, their foreign policy, for example, sometimes take an unexpected turn.
Papa, 2 minutes. Ве молам вашите впечатоци од оваа меѓународна конференција за меѓуетничките односи.
Јас сум впечатлен од тоа че се провежда такава конференција со участието на специјалисти и експерти од Македонија, од Молдова, както и од други балкански страни и страни од Јужна Европа по еден исклучително важен проблем който занимава не само тези две страни, но и всички држави од региона. Конференцијата е добре организирана. И явно нещата се поставят в форма, която предполага анализ. Следи анализ на процесите, явленията, а за съжаление проблемите и конфликтите в двете страни.
Како мислите, може има ли шанси да се решават тия проблеми?
Според мен ситуацията в двете страни, в Молдова и Македония, е твърде различна, тъй като в Молдова събитията са взели конфликтен характер от самото начало. И сега имаме ситуация, при която нещата постепенно се реализират към успокояване. Конфликтът е минал, републиката Принесовка се отделила, Молдова държи да запази своята държавност. Нещата отиват повече към преговори. Ето, има миналата година, тези проблеми са били поставени на конференция на ОССЕ в Истанбул. Подписана е една декларация, с която Русия поема ангажимент постепенно да започне изтеглянето на своята 14-та армия от така наречената Приднестровска република. За съжаление обаче ми се струва на мен, че в Македония 10 години вече нещата се заплитат все повече. Проблемите не се решаваха, а се отлагаха, което според мен повишава степента на напрежение. Ако можем така да го кажем, докато тук в Молдова пика на напрежението отмина, Македония като че ли ще дойде тепърво. Аз се надявам това да стане по цивилизован начин, по мирен начин, чрез разговори между двете основни етнически общности, между мажоритарното население, както и албанското малцинство.
Цели ден поштипете јуја за тја вене тунак от конференцку, тре тоа е мрданијан дретник на Молдави, на Македонии, по еден вендет фтинјат Балканите.
Po e mira këtu është që njerëz nga shoqëria civile nga Maqedonia, si shqiptarët një kështu dhe Maqedonas, janë mbledhë këtu në Moldavi për të parë eksperiencën e marrëdhënieve ndëretnike në Moldavi dhe pastaj për të reflektuar ndaj kësaj në lidhje me Maqedoninë.
Cilët janë, domethënë, përshtypjet e juaja sa i përket zgjidhjes së problemeve ndërnacionale në Moldavi dhe Maqedoni me që ndëgjuat edhe palën njërën palë dhe palën tjetër?
Problemet ndëretnike në Moldavi dhe në Maqedoni ndryshojnë, nuk janë të njëjta, sepse në Maqedoni ne kemi grupe etnike, kurse në Moldavi shohim këtu që ka grupe nacionale, jo në atë sensin që kemi në Maqedoni, dhe problemet ndryshojnë sipas vendit. Dhe mendoj që në qofë se në Moldavi problemet kanë shkuar në një pikë kur rajonet tëra virtualisht janë të shkputura nga Moldavia në Maqedoni. Akoma kemi një bashkë ekzistencë, por mendoj që në qovë se edhe theksin këtu, që në qovë se nuk ndërmerën hapa konkrete, në këtë ras nga pala Maqedonse, në qovë se nuk ka një bashkëpunim me disë palës Maqedonse dhe Shqiptarët, e do gjindëm në një përbalë një situatë kur do jetë te përvojnë për të zhjithur të pak në njërë pasore.
Për sega ste pobogat iso edno iskustvo od Moldavija za rešavanje na međuetničkite konflikti. Koji se vašite pečatuci ovo?
Pa, pečatucite se identični so site vas što ste členovi na ova delegacija. Ušte se premnogu sveži za da možeme da izvlečeme nekakav zaključok, no vidovme jedno na vistina podeleno opštestvo. Iako naslovot na našiot projekt je podeleno opštestvo, ne verujem deka ona što ovde će go sretneme je fizički podeljeno opštestvo, kada što u jedna država patuvajki od jedan kraj do drug morame na opredeljeni teritoriji da pokažuvame patni ispravi, pasošot da go vadime i tako natamo. To zboruva deka raznite segmenti na ovo opštestvo ke mora da najdat način da gi rešat svojite vnatrišnji problemi za da izgradat jedna единствена држава, доколку тоа им е целта, воспротивно, како што секогаш е отворена можност да се разбира и државите и да исчезнат, и да се распаднат.
Дали мислите дека Македонија е по една повисок степен на решавањето на проблемите или пак Молдова?
Македонија исто така е етнички поделено општество, меѓутоа тоа досега ние го гледавме повеќе во некоја теоретска смисла, додека не дојдовме во оваа земја и не видовме како една физички поделена територија изгледа. Од друга страна, оно што слушнавме од некои од панелистите пак која посетија Македонија, тие велат дека да, Македонија не е територијално поделена, нема барикади помеѓу териториите кои што ги раздвојуваат етничките групи, но затоа има високи емоционални бариери меѓу луѓето, чувства на емоции кои што ги раздвојуваат етничките групи. Може би од таа констатација има и нешто да се научи, а патот тие се разбира. Разговор, отворен разговор за проблемите, барање солуции, одење во пресрет на проблемите и барање солуции пред проблемите да предизвикаат штета, експлозија, да речеме некако.
Благодарам.
Молам.
Precedent acestei conferințe care a avut loc la Struga, în Macedonia, că între țările noastre, în cazul conflictelor interetnice dintre țările noastre, există extraordinar de multe similitudini. Există și unele diferențe. Că nimeni nu cunoaște problemele cu care se confruntă Republica Moldova. Și aceasta este, în mare parte, nu datorită unui boicot, că nimeni nu boicotează informațional Republica Moldova, ci datorită unor greșeli, să spun, și din partea noastră, poate, care au făcut, au condus la lipsa prezenței noastre în mass media internațională. Am să mă opresc aici, am vrut să vorbesc și despre rolul organizației.
Cred că o дополнительно несколько размышлений, которые мне приходилось еще высказывать.
Дело в том, что некоторые из вас существовали речь о Украине, и я бы сказал, что это не первая тема, конечно, Россия за нас, за ситуацию, как и нас, но все так, его дискуссия, это только помню, дискутанты, работали. Мисли смо тој да слушам се сдруженија на граѓани, а невладина организација се прихаќа како термин кој што дојде или од полна денес да со пет подписи, со пет члена може да се формира една. И сега, дали е наистина таму случајот и дали на невладините организации го користат тоа за да наистина влија да се изволени свеста на тези. Стратешка цел во која што на што ќе работаат и кои што правици ќе се движат. Со кои што ние се соочуваме. Потоа политичкото влијание, кој што е многу силно изразено, кој што не му дозволува на невладиниот сектор да на некој начин да битно влие за да се изголеми свеста, да се минуваат некои закони кои што би били од интерес на групата која што сега имало неколку иницијативи, но немаше конкретни резултати да се влие, да се има простор за невладините организации, бидејќи влијанието на политичките партии е многу јако и не дозволува на некој начин да мислам дека има време за дискусија, за да поразговараме за она што вас интересира, односно
како да ги наречам и опозициони. Ние за жал нема
I said, you have the email address, I found out, so sending the staff either to Professor Maresky in Macedonia or to Mrs. Kureci in Moldavia, and then you will find a way how these two stuff should be united and email, fax, and to those who are.
Lima, go
ahead. You were perfect hosts. I must say that, as I said at the beginning, that this whole project was done by two men, not by me. We had Anna, a professional. On the other side, we had Liana, a volunteer. So please excuse us for the problems that we might have created, but we did it from our good heart and our good intentions. The future may be.
I mean, the conflict in, as far as I understand, in Macedonia is coming up. People are mobilized. People are involved at an ethnic border. There are very few who would be ready and who are able to communicate between those borders. People are not speaking, I mean, Albanians are speaking Macedonian, Macedonians are not speaking Albanian. There are different faiths and a very deep mistrust. On the other side in Macedonia, on the other side in Moldova, the conflict is not an ethnic conflict, it's a political territorial conflict between those who are interested in building up a new state, a national state with all sorts of limits, and between those who want somehow to keep in life the old Soviet type of thinking, social organization, linguistic policy, and etc. So that's one difference. Another major difference that the real conflict, I mean, the small-scale civil war, I mean, with around 1,000 people, I mean, to be killed, took place in 92. And 8 years later, people are accommodated to this divided country. So it comes up that you can live in a country like that. You, as long as a country is not divided, you are horror. You cannot imagine how that. But we were living in the divided Berlin. We see how the divided Cyprus is looking like. It's very negative, but people are living there. We see how the divided Moldavia is looking like, and that shows us to take very seriously any other possibility of division, because you believe, okay, we can confront, because anyhow at the very end we solve the problem. No, at the end we have division, we have the wall. And you see how that wall is looking like, and therefore you must think about the wall, about the division in a bilingual, binational, but still comprehensive society as a very serious option, which somehow must be avoided. So it's real, it's not imagination, it's not a fantasy, it happens. So that's very important. I think that's an important message. It's possible. Yeah, it's possible.
Okay.
Please, I would like to invite you to take a glass of wine. So, and as a host, I would like to say some words. I appreciate very much, first of all, that finally after, because it happened, but we changed several times. You're coming to Moldova. I'm very happy that finally you managed to come in Moldova and we completed this project, and I hope it was useful. And really maybe it's difficult for us also to find out such information. And I hope finally you'll have an interest in the book, which might be useful for those who are interested in this particular topic. And also appreciate very much that we have with us Mr. Kaltamas, with whom we started initially this idea of having such not typical, something unusual, I see, because it was really an experience, this project. Also happy that we have also outsiders who are not from these countries, Mr. Avinikeka and Mr. Parvano. Is he not yet? And Unfortunately, we failed to have some other experts from Russia and Ukraine and Romania, as we suppose. So, you see, not always it happens like we would like it to be. And I also appreciate very much that I have the support of our team from Moldova, which was also very diversified. We probably was also
between us. It's a small example that we can collaborate, we can communicate, and we can overpass all these barriers that probably to some extent artificial were created in our society. So I wish you that coming back make good things. It will be passed to our people, and we will provide the same ideas somewhere.
Norok.
I would like to thank once more our hosts. I will not make a speech, no more speeches. We have been talking.
So I invite you now, official part finished. Please.
And I'd like that you, in some event of Soros, sometime in the future, to open this glass and to remind us.
Thank
you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Cela
marche.
Cochon.
Cochon.